Here's how to remove the rear wheel bearing from your vehicle. Now, this is an 04 Silverado 1500, but the particular make and model doesn't really matter. The process is the same. So what I've done is a bunch of pre-disassembly already, but you have to take the wheel off, the axle out, and there's always a seal that you need to take off first to expose the bearing, and then you have to kind of hammer on it and pry on it with a chisel or something. But once that is out, and this is the new one that's got to go in afterwards. But once that's out, the bearing is exposed. Now the bearing consists of these rollers here and then this tracker on the outside. So what we have to do is reach in, grab on the inside, and kind of hammer it out in a way that pulls on it. So that is hard without specialized equipment, but fortunately I've got that right here and I will show you how that works. So this is two different kits here. The bottom one is a slide hammer kit. This is the slide hammer. It's got a threaded end on it, and it's got this, I think, 5-pound piece here in the middle that slides on this rail, and when you slide on it backwards, it will bang into this guy and basically, in a hammer-like way, yank on whatever's attached to the end of this threaded end. Okay. Now what we're going to attach on there is one of these guys from this kit, which is specially made for removing rear wheel or rear axle bearings. They come in different sizes, but basically what they do is they take this end and you stick it inside the bearing so that it hooks inside, and the other end you can thread your slide hammer into and begin to yank it out. So I'm going to show you how it works in action. All right, so what I'm going to do is stick the hook end of this guy in through the bearing and then swivel it so it flattens out behind the bearing, and then I'm going to go ahead and take this nut and tighten it until this washer has the bearing clamped securely between the hook and this washer, so this thing is hanging on really tightly, so when we do our slide hammering, it's not coming sprung and unsprung on you. So you want to make sure you get that tight. So here's how you do that. And you want to use the biggest one that fits in here, so that ideally you're pulling on you're not hammering on the rollers, you want to be hammering on the outside housing if possible. All right, so now this guy is on here tight, and let's just use our wrench to tighten that up a little bit more so that now that it's tight, this thing is on here rock solid. I cannot move this thing, okay? All right, so then you want to connect your slide hammer. So just go ahead and stick it in and thread it all the way on. All right, so once that's tight, go ahead and tighten up the nut. Make sure it's tight, because you don't want any spring in the system so this thing can't bounce on you. And make sure you have your hearing protection on when you do this. And also make sure that you don't knock your vehicle off your jack stands or anything like that, because this can be kind of hazardous. But once you have this on here, you can take this 5-pound piece and just begin to hammer it backwards to start pulling out the bearing. So here we go. And there we go. That's it. Bearing came right out. So this is a really neat tool, perfect for this kind of thing. But that's really all there is to it. Hope that was helpful. Thanks for watching.